Hello everyone, thank you for watching my videos. So today I want to talk to you about this phone I did unboxing last week, the Samsung Galaxy S21 5G. So I'll just give you some experience. I tried and tested with iPhone XR, and so what I did, I tested the face recognition, biometric face recognition, and how to set it up. With iPhone, it takes a little bit longer to set it up. Basically, it will scan your face better, I guess. But I test both of them to see how fast they will recognize you. And I test it at dark and at light. So it looks like Samsung do as good job as iPhone does. It's pretty quickly, like not always. iPhone sometimes faster, but it's only like quarter of a second. But when you do it dark, I think iPhone better. It will recognize your face. But when you wear a mask, iPhone will not recognize. But with this phone, you have fingerprint recognition biometric. So it's much helpful, because you just push your finger, like the thumb on, and it will recognize. That's a big benefit to have like this phone versus to iPhones right now, like iPhone 12. You have to enter your password every time you want to use it in public due to the mask. And the mask may last for another few months or maybe a year. Nobody knows exactly. I know not everybody wears a mask, but again, in situation right now, most people when on public in a store, they wear a mask. Second, like the feeling of the phone is pretty good in my hand. This phone was for my wife, so I just did unboxing and want to talk about this phone for you guys. So the display, it's perfect. It's very crispy, like clear, very nice. Everything works smooth on this phone. Design, it's beautiful. She didn't get the case yet, but I think she's waiting for the case, because looks like it's very easy to scratch, and if you drop, I can feel the pain, it will break. Okay, another thing, compared to pictures, it's perfectly good. All the picture I took, it was very nice and brighter than iPhone I use. A little bit brighter looks like, but it's very nice, natural colors, good. I always like Samsung for camera. They have very good cameras. The reason I recommend to get the Samsung to my wife versus to iPhone, not only the price, because the price come up much better on this Samsung versus to iPhone, but also because of the apps. So currently I was using iPhone, and I'm using iPhone for the past I bought it I think in April, around September probably. So you do the math. I use it for about 5 months already. The iPhone, I do all this video. Even right now, the video is recorded on my iPhone XR, and I like it. The only negative I don't like about every time you go to the store, you have to use your PIN, which is annoying. Second, when you want to find an app with Android, you got much more apps to use. Also, most of the apps which comes for free or for ads app, when you use a free app, but they have some ads, they don't give you that much app with Android versus to the Apple Store. Because with Apple Store, you have to use, I guess they're paying more fee. That's why it costs more for the app creator to be on the platform. And that's why they bring this cost to everybody else. They share this cost with you. So for example, I try to use the ad to create some images, like editing. With Android, it's free and it gives you much more features in it, much better features. With Apple Store, Not if you trying the free version, every time you want to use one of the features, you have to watch ads. Real annoying. Or you have to purchase. But even you purchase, it does not have all the features which Android have. So you are minimized here, like on the features. I'm not sure about all the apps, but that's what I find out hard way, that Android, it's better customized phone. It's much easier to transfer the files. I test this phone to transfer files to my desktop. It's very easy, no app required, just plug in and play. Like you plug it in, you copy your files to your desktop. With iPhone, I can remove the files, and it sometimes cannot even remove it. It's kind of stay still on iPhone, have to deal it manually. But the problem also that with iPhone, I still didn't figure out and didn't try much, but I cannot upload videos on my iPhone. You have to have set up the app for that and software in order to transfer the files to iPhone. And maybe it's not even possible. I'm not sure. I didn't go in details, but I tried it a few times, and I tried the app and software they gave, and it was really hard and takes a lot of time. So I just give up. I don't upload any files to iPhone. That's a very bad, I guess. If you want to do editing, if you use the phone for editing or movies, or want to put some video on your phone, that's why I'm still considered to go to Android as well, maybe with a bigger screen, since I need bigger screens a little bit. It would be nicer for me, but still this screen is really big, and I think it's on average probably will be the most sell out phones, S21, and I'm not sure if the people like the bigger one, like Plus, but I think this phone, it's most reasonable for most people to buy, because if you wear your phone in your pocket, that's a phone you need to buy, because the bigger phone will be really too large. That's all for today. If you have any questions, please comment below. Thank you guys for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next video.